Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Shafer here. Check out this new model I designed. What is it? It is a Ballywog. What's a Ballywog? Well, I'll tell you. It is a ball-shaped extraterrestrial creature that has arms and legs, and it has eyes sticking out of its head, and it can open and close its mouth and do a whole assortment of other tricks that I'll show you at the end of the video. Want to learn how to fold him or her? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this Ballywog, I used a 10-inch square of commie, but you could easily use 6-inch commie, or you could even use a sheet of printer paper cut square, but then you won't have color-changed eyes or mouth. So let's begin white side up, and let's fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. We're gonna start out by folding a water bomb base. So let's unfold and rotate and fold in half diagonally in this direction. Now let's fold this corner to the top. And turn over right to left. And let's fold this corner to the top. Okay, now we're going to open up the big pocket, stick your hand inside, and let's bring these two corners together and flatten. And here we have the water bomb base. Let's rotate, and now let's fold this corner up to the top where the crease hits the edge, but we're just going to make a crease mark. So line it up and make a little crease mark there, and unfold, and now let's fold the corner to the crease mark. And once again, we're just gonna make a crease mark right there. And unfold, and now let's fold the corner to the crease mark, and this time we're going to fold all the way across it. Okay, now we're going to make one more crease mark. So let's bring this edge to the top, and when you do that, make sure that this crease aligns with the crease behind it. And when it touches the top edge, make a crease mark. And this time make it extra sharp so you can recognize it later. And now let's unfold and let's rotate. And let's fold this front flap up so that this corner touches this point. And let's repeat on this side. Okay, let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap up so that this corner touches our crease mark right in the middle there. And now let's wrap this flap inside right over this edge. Like that, and rotate, and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold the flap up to this point. By the way, we're making the arms. And now let's fold the flap inside right over this edge. Like that. And now let's rotate and let's fold these flaps up. These are gonna be the legs, the little itsy bitsy legs. Okay, now let's turn over top to bottom and let's fold this flap up so that the corner touches this point. And let's repeat on this side. Now we're making the eyes. Okay, let's rotate and let's fold this flap up so that it goes to our crease mark right in the middle, just like we did before. And rotate and let's repeat on this side. Okay, now let's unfold this flap and unfold this flap. And let's fold the flap up right on this crease. And we just need to fold it right to here. Now let's bring this edge over and flatten. Now let's rotate and let's fold this flap to this point. And unfold. And now let's refold the flap so that this crease aligns with this edge. So we just fold it like this, and the crease aligns with the edge. And the fold should come very close to this point, but not quite there. Okay, now let's fold this flap over on this crease. And let's open the pocket and squash. Now let's fold this flap down. And there we have our eye. Okay, let's fold this flap up on this edge. So we're just folding horizontally. And now let's repeat on this side. So let's unfold the flap and unfold here, and let's fold the flap up and fold right here, and let's fold the flap over and squash and rotate, and let's fold this flap up to here. Unfold, and let's refold it so that the crease aligns with this edge. And now let's fold the flap over right on this crease. And let's open up this pocket and squash it. Now let's bring the little flap down, and here we have our second eye. Let's fold the flap up on this edge. Okay, so here we have the two eyes. Let's lift these flaps up, and you can just kind of swivel the eyes so that they point forward. And let's unfold this back flap. And we are ready to inflate our Ballywog. So put a finger in here and a finger in here. So we have the flaps kind of going in the four directions. And now you want to try to inflate it right into the mouth, but you have to be careful that no air escapes. So you really have to cover the mouth with your mouth. Here goes. Make sure to hold on to it, otherwise it'll fly out. And there it is. Okay, so if you like it like that, you're done. But if you wanna just kinda fix it up a little bit, just get out any little glitches, I'd recommend that. I think that the top and bottom mouth look good when it's curved. And they also operate better. And this crease here, or fold, let's extend that to our crease mark. And same on this side. Okay, that's looking pretty good. And this is how the mouth operates. You just close it like that. And there's the Ballywog speaking. And you can name your Ballywog whatever you want. I think I'm gonna name this guy Moji. I just like that name because it sounds like emoji. And this is sort of has character, so he's Moji. Hi, my name is Moji. All right, so there you have your Ballywog. And like I said in the beginning of the video, it can do many tricks. So I'm going to show you now all of the tricks that your Ballywog can do. Okay, what can it do? It can dance around and it can pull out its legs and kick or dance, waddle back and forth. Or if you hold right here and push in, it can talk. Or if you hold right here and push in, it can dance headbang style. I like this because you just can do a little bit of movement and the thing really bounces. And what else? Oh, you can fold these flaps out like this and they can become wings and your Ballywog can fly. Oh, and this can become the landing gear. But okay, what else? Let's bring the legs back into place and the arms can fold down. And Moji can stand in a variety of different ways. Like this, that's on this edge. Or if you fold these edges in, then you can balance on any one of them. Or it can balance on its mouth. Or if you fold the hands in, then it can balance on these edges, like that. Another trick your Ballywog can do is if you push in the belly, then it can stand on your two fingers and even go upside down. And if you fold your Ballywog from 6-inch paper, then it can balance on one finger and go upside down and around, and it's finger trained. It just kind of clings onto the finger right by the legs. You might have to push the belly in a little bit. And out of 6-inch paper, this is how the head banging looks. Okay, what else? Moji can wink or close its eyes and go to sleep. And Moji can collapse. So let's push him in like this. And to put Moji into hibernation mode, I'm going to stick the arms back into the pockets. And what's really cool is that the eyes can slip into each other. So let's collapse this flap like this, and this flap sticks under here, and then this flap collapses and it goes into this pocket right here, like that. And now he's locked into hibernation mode. And now you can store Moji very compactly and securely. And then when you want to inflate him again, you just have to pull out the eyes, straighten them out, open them up, and blow them up. Straighten them out again and shape to taste, and we're back in business. Hi there. And what else? You could juggle them. I tend to juggle my origami models, as you well know. And yeah, so there you have it. And like I said, you can name this guy whatever you want, and he could be like a Pokemon character, a new Pokemon character. And he could probably even fit into the Pokeball, or he can just be your friend, and you can feed him fingers. Ah! Alright, hope you guys like this model, and let me know in the comments below if you find any other tricks that your Ballywog can do. And now, Moji is going to eat the camera. Yum, 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 yum. Alright, see you guys later. Bye.
In order to inflate the Ballywog, you have to put your mouth on the whole thing, so no air escapes. So, here goes. Oops, I forgot to say you have to hold on. Okay, so let's... hold on, like this maybe?